In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace, mercy, and peace from our Heavenly Father and our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. I would like to start this service by giving thanks to Lord God Almighty, our Heavenly Father, and our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, in the words of Psalm 135. Glory to you, O Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise Him, O ye servants of the Lord, you who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing praises to His name, for it is pleasant. For the Lord has chosen Jacob for Himself, Israel for His special treasure. For I know that the Lord is great, and our Lord is above all gods. Whatever the Lord pleases, He does, in heaven and in earth, in the seas and in all the deep places. He causes the vapors to ascend from the ends of the earth. He makes lightning for the rain. He brings the wind out of His treasures. He destroyed the firstborn of Egypt, both of man and beast. He sends signs and wonders into the midst of you, O Egypt, upon Para and all his servants. He defeated many nations and slew mighty kings. Sion, king of the Amorites, Og, king of Bashan, and all the kings of Canaan, and gave their lands as a heritage to Israel, his people. Your name, O Lord, endures forever. Your fame, O Lord, throughout all generations. For the Lord will judge his people, and he will have compassion on his servants. The idols of the nations are silver and gold, the work of men's hands. They have mouths, but they do not speak. Eyes they have, but they do not see. They have ears, but they do not hear. Nor is there any breath in their mouths. Those who make them are like them. So is everyone who trusts in them. Bless the Lord, O house of Israel. Bless the Lord, O house of Aaron. Bless the Lord, O house of Levi. You who fear the Lord, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord out of Zion, who dwells in Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen to that. Our first hymn sung by my beautiful daughter Andrea is How Great Is Our God.
Thank you.
Our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, now and forever. Forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the words of comfort. Our Savior Lord Jesus Christ says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Amen. Compassion and forgiveness belong to the Lord our God. Though we have rebelled against him, let us then renounce our willfulness and ask his mercy by confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Christ, have mercy. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Lord, have mercy. Let us therefore, in a moment of silence, confess our sins before our Heavenly Father and our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, in penitence and faith. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with heartly repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today we are observing the third Sunday in Lent. Lent in Western Christian Church calendar, a period of penitential preparation for Passover. We beseech thee, Almighty God, look upon the hearty desires of thy humble servants and stretch forth the right hand of thy majesty to be our defense against all our enemies, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first reading is from Isaiah chapter 55. Glory to you, O Lord. Come, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you who have no money, come, buy and eat. Yes, come, buy wine and milk, without money and without price. Why do you spend money for what is not bread, and your wages for what does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and let your soul delight itself in abundance. Incline your ear, and come to me. Hear, and your soul shall live. And I will make an everlasting covenant with you, the sure mercies of David. Indeed, I have given him as a witness to the people, a leader and commander for the people. Surely you shall call a nation you do not know, and nations who do not know you shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God and the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, and he will have mercy on him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth, and make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. For you shall go out with joy, and be led out with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth into singing before you, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the cypress tree, and instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle tree. And it shall be to the Lord for a name, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Amen to that. Glory to you, our Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Our second reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 10, from verses 1 to 13. Glory to you, O Christ. Moreover, brethren, I do not want you to be unaware that all our fathers were under the cloud, all passed through the sea, all were baptized into Moses, in the cloud and in the sea. All ate the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. But with most of them God was not well pleased, for their bodies were scattered in the wilderness. Now these things became our examples, to the intent that we should not lust after evil things as they also lusted, and do not become idolaters as were some of them. As it is written, the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. Nor let us commit sexual immorality as some of them did, and in one day 23,000 fell. Nor let us tempt Christ as some of them also tempted, and were destroyed by serpents. Nor complain, as some of them also complain, and were destroyed by the destroyer. Now all these things happened to them as examples, and they were written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the ages have come. Therefore, let him who thinks he stands take heed lest he fall. No temptation has overtaken you, except such as is common to men. But God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted beyond what you are able, but with the temptation will also make the way of escape, that you may be able to bear it. This is the word of our God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Christ was revealed in flesh, vindicated in the spirit, seen by angels, preached among the nations, believed on in the world, received up in glory. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Christ. There were present at that season some who told him about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And Jesus answered and said to them, "Do you suppose that these Galileans were worse sinners than all other Galileans, because they have suffered such things? I tell you no. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. Or those 18 on whom the tower in Siloam fell and killed them, do you think that they were worse sinners than all that other men who dwelt in Jerusalem? I tell you no. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish." He also spoke this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. Then he said to the keeper of his vineyard, "Look, for 3 years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree and find none. Cut it down. Why does it use up the ground?" But he answered and said to him, "Sir, let it alone this year also, until I dig around it and fertilize it, and if it bears fruit, well, but if not, after that you can cut it down." Praise to you, our Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of God. Thanks be to our God. Amen. May I speak in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. For I am risen, you shall rise up. For it is the heritage of servants of God, that you shall keep to peace and righteousness all the days of your life. The Lord does not say no to what Cross said yes already 2,000 years ago. The Lord say yes to all the desires of your heart, for I am within you. The Lord said yes to all your heart desires. Who can annul it? The Lord said yes to all that you have asked. Who can stand against it? O ye servant, now that you are risen in the Lord for the eternal life, keep going till the end. For the Lord is going with you to Emmaus. The Lord is with you on your journey to Holy Land. The Lord promised you to live down here as it is in heaven. So you shall, for it is the heritage of servants of God. The Lord shines his light on you. In righteousness you shall rise up. In faithfulness you shall keep going. In holiness you shall live. For I, the Lord, live within you. For I, the Lord, make the way for you. Well, there is no way, for I am with you. I live in you through all your circumstances. I shall keep you in the newness of life. I shall keep you in holiness, for you are risen with me. When the days are drawing to an end, keep the peace, for peace of the Lord surpasses all understanding. Be filled with the holy love of God towards all. For God is all, for God is with you in all. Love all without an exception. Love all God's children. Love all God's people. Love all. For God's love is in you through his Son. For God is the source of love for all. For For God is love in all. For God's love is in His Son. God's love is in us through His Son, our Lord Emmanuel. God only Son, Lord of all Lords, Christ the Messiah, Lord Jesus. Amen. I say this to you, my brethren, all God's promises are yes and amen, and they shall come to pass at God's timing. Therefore, wait on the Lord. I say, wait for the Lord to act on your behalf and defeat the enemy. Wait for the Lord through your suffering. Wait for the Lord through patience. Wait on the Lord for the eternity through His Son, our Lord Emmanuel. On the 14th of January 2020, I woke up being given this word. Spirit of God was upon us. We crossed the desert Kadesh, came to Holy Land, the land of milk and honey. Those who give out of their heart to the poor, surely their rewards are in heaven. Those who seek the Lord pray day and night. Your prayers are heard in heaven by my Father who is in heaven, will receive what they have asked in due course. Whoever asks, receives. Surely God is with this nation, with His people. Hallelujah, hallelujah, amen to that, for the glory of God the Father and the Son. Amen. Our second hymn, sung by my beautiful daughter Andrea, is Make Me Channel of Your Peace. Amen.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, you make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. Is it pardoning
before our Heavenly Father and our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven and was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. The peace of the Lord always be with you. Let us pray before our Heavenly Father and our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord for courage to give up other things and to give ourselves to him this Lent, saying, Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Give your church the courage to give up her preoccupation with herself and to give more time to your mission in the world. May the blood and water flowing from the side of Jesus bring forgiveness to your people and help us to face the cost of proclaiming salvation. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Give your world the courage to give up war, bitterness and hatred, and to seek peace. May the shoulders of the risen Jesus, once scorched by soldiers, bear the burden of political and military conflict in our world. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Give us the courage to give up quarrels, strife and jealousy in our families, neighborhoods and communities. May the presence of the risen Jesus, his body once broken and now made whole, bring peace and direction as we live with one another. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Give us the courage to give up our selfishness as we live for others and to give time, care and comfort the sick. May the wounded hands of Jesus bring his healing touch and the light of his presence fill their rooms. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Give us the courage to give up our fear of death and to rejoice with those who have died in faith. May the feet of risen Jesus, once nailed to the cross, walk alongside the dying and breathe in their agony, and walk with us and all your church through death to the gate of glory. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer, now and in eternity. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In a moment of silence, let each of us make our own prayer and petitions before our Heavenly Father and our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts, we lift them up unto the Lord. Let us give thanks unto our God. It is meet and right so to do. And now we give you thanks, because each year you give us this joyful season when we prepare to celebrate the Paschal mystery with mind and heart renewed. You give us a spirit of loving reverence for you and of willing service to our neighbor. As we recall the saving acts that give new life in Christ, you bring the image of your Son to perfection within our hearts. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Most High. Amen. We praise you and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. Thank you, Lord. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, Thank you, Lord. Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice, made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Christ is the bread of life. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all your saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father. Now and forever, forever and ever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I'm not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. Body of Christ, to keep in eternal life. Amen. Blood of Christ, to keep in eternal life. Amen. Eternal God, comfort of the afflicted and healer of the broken, you have fed us at the table of life and hope. Teach us the ways of gentleness and peace, that all the world may acknowledge the kingdom of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you that you graciously feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the body and blood of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. By this you assure us of your favor and goodness towards us. We are incorporated into mystical body of your Son, the blessed company of all faithful people. We are heirs through hope of your everlasting kingdom. By the merits of Christ's precious death and passion, assist us with your grace, Heavenly Father, that we may continue in that fellowship and walk in goodness the way you have prepared for us, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever, forever and ever. Amen. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son. He is the sacrifice for our sins, that we might live through him. If God loves us so much, we ought to love one another. Amen. God, who from the dead of sin raised you to new life in Christ, keep you from falling and set you in the presence of his glory, and the blessing of the God Almighty, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Joy with peace, amendment of life, time for true repentance, the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit, and perseverance in good works, grant us, O Almighty and merciful Lord. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Our final hymn, sung by my beautiful daughter Andrea, is All My Days. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
The light.